Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
A very warm welcome to our Songs of Praise. Thank you so much for coming along this evening. What a wonderful way to end our fantastic flower festival. We've called tonight's Songs of Praise the year we have missed, for obvious reasons, really. And so we're going to be singing our way through the church's year, starting with Advent and ending with Pentecost, and then for good measure throwing in two really good belters at the end, just to soak up any gas you've got left in the meter. It's not often we get to beat the shops and sing O Come All Ye Faithful in the middle of July, but tonight is our opportunity. Now, hopefully you've all got a service sheet. All equipped with a pink sheet with the words on. Please either stand or sit for the hymns. It's entirely up to you. Do your own thing. Don't, I suggest, sit down too heavily at the end, because the result will be your chair will sink further into the grass, and it'll be harder to get out of. Now, I think that's all from me.
Have I missed anything? Can you think of anything?
No.
Right.
Djokovic won.
Sorry?
Oh, Djokovic won.
Did he?
Djokovic won.
Oh, Djokovic won, apparently. That's one Italian out of the running. Right. We're going to continue with an opening prayer or two and then start singing. So, let's be still and quiet as we meet with God in this place.
Heavenly Father, in our fellowship together, our singing and our prayer, we hear your voice whisper, "See, I am doing a new thing." God of new beginnings, grant us a new heart for worship, a new heart for your people, a new love for our neighbour, and a new willingness for service, that in your name we might be lifted high in this place and this time. Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the breath of life. We thank you for the wonderful orchestration of the cosmos, the whole creation expressing your glory and steadfast love. We celebrate the gift of music making, which lifts our hearts and enables us to praise you with body, mind, and spirit. This evening, we offer you our music, as we sing to the music maker, our great creator, who loves harmony, rich diversity working together in unity. Lift our praises and enable us to sing with the angels in heaven. Amen.
Amen.
I meant to say at the beginning that some people have lovely voices. Some people think they have lovely voices. Some people do have dreadful voices, but some people only think they have dreadful voices. Whichever category you come into, it doesn't matter. What does matter is that you bless the people around you by singing as loudly as you can. Now, we're going to begin each of our seasons, as it were, with a tiny Bible reading, and here comes a tiny reader.
Now is the time to wake out of sleep, for now our salvation is nearer than when we first believed.
And so we commence with, not surprisingly, Advent, and lo, he comes with clouds descending.
Come, sing, come, sing, send me one.
Without further ado, we move into the second of our Advent hymns, O Come, Emmanuel.
Of Christmas.
To us a child is born, to us a son is given, and his name will be called the Prince of Peace.
Now, we've deliberately chosen these two Christmas carols because they have cracking descants. And if you're feeling really brave after 15 months of no singing, go for it. It's also occurred to me there's a lot of people, you may not have noticed, but over the lockdown, a lot of people have moved to Tenterden, and we have a wonderful range of new faces who've joined us, and they've never heard us sing. Now, whether they stay after tonight or not depends on how well I think you can do a good old Christmas descant. So we'll start this with O Come All Ye Faithful. Thank you. That was a very, very valiant effort. Fantastic. Well, we're not going to pause too long to get your breath back. We're going to move on to that marvellous hymn, Hark the Herald Angels Sing.
Say time passes more quickly the older you get. 1 minute it's Advent and the next it's Lent. We're going to throttle back a little bit now, and you might like to remain seated for this hymn because it's possibly a little more reflective before we pick up the pace as we reach Easter. But first, words from Psalm 51.
The sacrifice of God is a broken spirit, a broken and contrite heart he will not despise.
We sing, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross.
Thank you.
up if you're already a little hoarse. Oh, it's very good, this. We're going to move now to that glorious season of Easter. And for many of us here, it's really lovely. There are large numbers of people from all three of the churches, and it is fantastic to actually all come together and offer our worship. And for many of us, our Easter celebrations start at 6 o'clock down in the car park at St. John's Church. And it was rather fantastic this year, but it did lack in singing. So we're going to start now with See What a Morning. But first of all, I shall ask Margaret to read our Bible passage.
Very early in the morning, on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb just as the sun was rising. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
My little sister used to sing, "Thine be the glory, risen concrete, son." She hadn't quite understood the meaning, I don't think, but hopefully this evening we can, we're not going to raise the roof really, are we? We've done that, but we can belt this one out. So if you've still got the lungs, "Thine be the glory, risen conquering, son."
Amen.
Please, would you sit? Have a slight breather for just a moment. The great festival of Easter has several dimensions to it. There is Easter itself, of course, and the celebration of the resurrection, followed by feedback, followed by the Ascension, Easter in another dimension, and finally Pentecost, the coming of the Spirit. Now we have one Ascension hymn and one Pentecost hymn, so we'll roll those two together, so to speak. We're going to commence with, in a moment, Hail the Day That Sees Him Rise, and then turning the page, you'll see a very relaxed hymn, Spirit of the Living God. But first, our reading from Luke's Gospel.
Jesus lifted up his hands, and while he blessed his disciples, he parted from them.
Over to you, Geoffrey.
Bye.
Several of you looking heavenward and hoping that all this singing about the cloud and the skies and everything else isn't going to bring down the rain. I'm confident we will get by in dry weather, but we'll sit down now. We're going to sing Spirit of the Living God after Margaret has read our Bible verse. We're going to sing this one through twice, and I would suggest perhaps you might like to sit down and garner back your energy for the end. Okay.
You shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be my witnesses.
You.
Come up here. Is that the right height?
Probably much lower, but I hope you can hear me, because I think, like everybody else, I peaked too early. I think I lost my voice at Christmas and I haven't got it back yet. I couldn't let this moment go without jumping up towards a microphone. Those of you who come to Food for Thought will know that I think it was last month, when I was leading part of the service, I asked Lindsay to get up as one of our volunteers. And he admitted to me afterwards that throughout the very gentle activity that I asked him to do, he was absolutely terrified because he didn't trust that I wasn't going to do something that he didn't know. And he wasn't sure what the people behind him were doing all the way through it. Well, you can get me back because you're behind me now. But I know you would have had a bit of a frisson of fear when you saw me leap to my feet just then. I am here, and I'm going to be joined by Emma in a second, as a representative of, well, we're actually representing all three churches here. And I want to say, first of all, how hugely grateful we are to all the clergy for everything that they have done for us throughout the last 18 months or so. Well, yes, everybody. Yes. And we thought that this would be a perfect opportunity to say a special thank you to Lindsay and Jeanette, because I don't know about you, but there were times during the pandemic that the only thing that kept me going was knowing that Lindsay and Jeanette were rushing around, climbing up towers, shooting from one side to the other, taking photos, filming videos. I had the pleasure to be part of one of the filming sessions, which involved iPads and duct tape and step ladders, and you know, it was wonderful Heath Robinson invention. So I just think that they have gone absolutely above and beyond, and we are all so, so grateful that we wanted to say thank you to them and to their families who have had to put up with losing them to us for all this period of time. So thank you all. And we've got a little something to say thank you, because we really think you deserve a break. And not that we want you to go away, but go away somewhere. The idea is we've given you something to enable you to have a bit of a rest and a bit of a break once things get back to normal a bit more and you feel you can relax, because we really think you deserve it.
Thank you.
Kind of knew something was in the air, because Chris Brown kept saying, make sure you give Katie 2 minutes in the Songs of Praise. So we kind of knew something was happening, but we weren't sure what. Thank you so much for, well, everything, really. It's been such an honour and a privilege to do what we've done, and to know that we've made a bit of a difference to the last 18 months. None of it would have been possible without everybody pulling together and contributing and submitting stuff for Connect Up, for the Viral Times before that. That all depended on people chipping in and putting their 2 penny worth in. And some of you put more than 2 penny worth in, and we're grateful for that too. I think without a word of a lie, nothing, there's not been, and I've been in this game a bit longer than Jeanette, but in all my ministry of years, this has been, I think, the most unusual. It's been the most stretching. It's been the period of time that's taken me out of my comfort zone into areas that I never, ever dreamt that I would step into. But I have to say, it's been the most fantastic time as well, and that's not to minimise the suffering and the sadness that so many people have gone through. But the sense of reward, I think, that we've both gained, really, has been fantastic. And I just think you've been such a great bunch to minister to and with, and long may that continue. So, I don't know what's in here. One-way ticket, presumably.
Do you want us to... It won't explode.
Right.
Right, ladies first, you open yours.
Same time.
My goodness. Right.
Mine's a check. I don't know what yours is. and a really generous check. Thank you so much. I don't know. Well, we won't read this out on air, as it were, but we'll put something in the magazine and in Connect Up, and let you know what it is. Is that okay? I feel a bit embarrassed about all this, but thank you so much. Thank you.
I know you want to get home to watch football, so I'm not going to talk for so long. I'm also semi-speechless, but which you'll probably be pleased about. Thank you very much. Coming here has been the biggest blessing ever. I've had my parents to stay with me this weekend, and they have continually said that when the diocese placed me here, I completely landed on my feet. And to work with someone like Lindsay as well has been an utter blessing. But apart from anything else, the thing that I've been learning from here is the strength of this community, of this place. It's an incredible place. I have never experienced anything like it. And thank you so much for this. And I know that my family, who, you know, will also very much appreciate it. But the teamwork here, I mean, we had people who were more or less, when we had to lock the church, knocking on the doors saying, what can we do? And that just sums up this place. It is remarkable. And there is a real sense of the presence of God here in the different ways that people work. All of the church wardens, and I know church wardens have actually changed in some of the churches over lockdown, have been there every step of the way. And they have, you know, made phone calls and said, you know, sit down, take a break. And they have looked after us. But so have all of you. And, you know, when we reopened the church doors about a year ago and were able to come together once again and worship, there was just this wonderful sense of what we'd all been missing and the fact that it was... And tonight, I think this has just summed it up, really. It's just amazing to be back together, to be able to offer our prayers and our praises together, and to see you singing. And I know there's a few people here who have not, for various very good reasons, not ventured back before now. And thank you for coming. And that's just the kind of place this is. And we are all very, very blessed to be a part of it. So thank you to all of you. And we've got some more singing to do, so I shall move on swiftly.
We gave Margaret little snippets of readings to do, and we just wanted to see how she'd fare before giving her a longer reading. But she's done brilliantly. Right, Psalm 150. Are you going to sing Stanford four-part harmony?
Yeah.
You are.
Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty firmament. Praise him for his mighty deeds. Praise him according to his surpassing greatness. Praise him with trumpet sound. Praise him with lute and harp. Praise him with tambourine and dance. Praise him with strings and pipe. Praise him with clanging cymbals. Praise him with loud clashing cymbals. Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Now, we had to include this hymn. Geoffrey said he wasn't going to play at all if we didn't have this one. So, guide me, O thou great Redeemer.
Let me say for pain.
you please be seated and just rest before we make one last valiant attempt at singing. before we get to our last hymn, and we've chosen that especially because what finer note to end on than a hymn of thanksgiving. Before we do that, I can announce that there are, behind Geoffrey in the porch, there are cakes available, completely free. That doesn't mean they're suspect, just that they weren't bought or eaten during the Flower Festival weekend. So if you'd like to help yourselves, there's a few cakes there. Try not to stampede, try to socially distance, but they all need to go, really. And now Mary, where's Mary? There she is. Now Mary, I understand you're going to be ringing some lucky prize winners tomorrow morning. So if the phone rings, it could be Mary with the prize of a lifetime. One prize that it won't be is the hot air balloon, because we can announce that Jill Ashby, Jill Ashby, who works over in the social hub, was the day centre. Jill Ashby has won the hot air balloon voucher and the champagne, and she's very excited, and she knows about the prize, obviously. But the other prizes will be revealed tomorrow. Right, well, if you can't wait till tomorrow to find out, Mary's put them on the table on, where the raffle table was. Your names may be there, so you might want to wander in, grab a leftover cake, and check and check to see if you're a prize winner.
Can you say, I think we've raised over 1,000, and I thought in my wildest dreams if we make 500
on the raffle. Oh, wow, just on the raffle?
Yeah.
£1,000 on the raffle? Yeah. Oh, fantastic. Thank you very much. After the final hymn, there'll be some prayers, and then you're free to go. But thank you very much for being here this evening, and I hope your larynxes recover and that you've enjoyed a jolly good sing. Thank you. Right, Geoffrey, take it away. Nun dankit.
Seated. I think before we go, we should just say a very big thank you to Geoffrey. I think he's still looking for the foot pedals on that organ. And also to the choir, who have done a sterling effort tonight in keeping us all going. So thank you very much, choir, as well. And now a final prayer and the blessing. Let our lives be a song of praise. Let our actions sing out God's love. Let our music be a joy and blessing. And as the melodies melt into silence, may the profound peace of God root us in the eternal music of heaven. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among every single one of you and all those whom you love and all who love you this night and always.
Amen. Amen.
Now, I think there is only one way to end this evening.
We're not creative enough, we're not positive enough.
It's coming home, it's coming home.